He's the front man of the legendary rock band Kiss, whose hits include Rock and Roll All Night and I Was Made for Loving You. Paul Stanley, did you know this? He's also an artist. And he's in Atlanta this weekend for an exhibition at the Wentworth Gallery at Phipps Plaza. And that is where we find Buck Lamford standing by live. How lucky are you? And I'm pretty sure that a lot of people didn't know how talented Paul Stanley really is as an artist.
No, we knew he was a talented musician, yeah. But who knew how much talent he had as an artist? And I don't get starstruck very often, Sharon. I've met a lot of people, but when I walked around the corner and there's Paul Stanley, I'm like, that's my youth growing up. Well, I'm not that much younger, but anyway.
I have shoes his age.
Whatever. It's not those. I can guarantee you those are not my age. Paul, how are you doing, man?
I'm doing great. Any chance I get to come to Atlanta is always amazing. I've been coming here since the days of the Electric Ballroom, Alex Cooley's.
Yeah.
And to be able to come here and show my art, the receptions have been phenomenal. I mean, we've had incredible turnouts and a lot of serious collectors have been taking pieces home with them, so it's great. People who love art and people who know nothing about art should all be here, because art is something for everybody. Whether it's tearing pages out of a magazine, you know, you should put something on your wall.
Well, and we want to show some of these paintings, but first I want to ask you this. I mean, how much of that, the rock and roll career, which you still play with Kiss, how much of that career obviously inspired when we look at the guitars and look in the scenes, what you do now?
Well, I think that rock and roll is based on freedom and the ability to go out and explore who you are. Without listening to anybody telling you what you can't do. So to me, art is the same thing. I started painting as a, kind of like a cathartic means of expression when I was going through a tough time years ago, and it's just developed from there. So for me, it's really about being independent, and I use a lot of colors. Some people say I'm a punk impressionist, and it's probably because, you know, to me, life is about color, and color affirms life. So I paint with a lot of colors.
Come on, let's take a look. Yeah, I think my favorite Kiss song might be "I Want to Rock and Roll All Night and Paint Every Day." That's how
me.
It went, right?
That's me. See this painting?
Yeah, I recognize that guy.
Here we go.
There you go.
Ready?
Separated at birth.
Yeah, you go.
But obviously, some other icons in Hollywood and rock and roll.
Yeah, you know, here's Marilyn, and it's wonderful to be able to paint people who are iconic, celebrate them, and have other people know right away who they are and want to take them home. So here's Marilyn. Here's the unbelievable Jimi Hendrix, who I was lucky enough to see twice.
Oh, wow.
So this is a recent piece. All these are fairly recent.
I love the guitars, too.
Yeah, the guitars are interesting because they're my signature model guitar that I designed. And now they're painted. These ones aren't for playing. They actually get put into a shadow box and framed so that they hang on the wall. They're new pieces. These flowers are something that I've been doing lately. And it's great because the great thing about flowers as art is that you never have to water them.
Ah, yes, low maintenance.
Yes, and they will last forever.
You're also a patriotic guy. You pointed out one that you're very proud of here. It's a very cool American flag. Tell us about that one.
Well, you know, we live in a time now where people sometimes confuse political views with patriotism. And no matter what you believe and who you believe, the fact is that we live in the greatest country on earth, and we need to respect our flag in the sense that we need to be proud of our country. And I think patriotism is cool. I do a lot of work with wounded warriors and with a lot of veterans groups, because the fact of the matter is people tend to believe that freedom is free, and it's only free for the people who don't do the sacrificing. So for me, the flag represents this great country and the people who make it great, and those, for the most part, happen to be the military.
Got about another minute. Let's take a walk back here and show some of the other pieces. So back when Kiss was in its rock and roll heyday, you weren't painting then. This is a relatively new talent that you discovered.
Yeah, it's something that I always knew I had, but it was something that was on the back burner, because when you're in hotel rooms most of the time during the year, you don't have much time for exploring anything else. But at this point, it's great. Truly, what I do every day is take my kids to school and then go to the studio and paint. So I'm painting 5 days a week at least. And again, the supply and demand thing has been just unbelievable. I think our last show, we had over 500 people show up. And obviously at the shows, I can't rub shoulders and meet everybody. I try to come out and say hi to everybody. Mm-hmm. But when people acquire a piece, then we get a chance to spend some time together. And again, you don't need an education in art to like art. And anybody who feels that they have to justify their opinion is been intimidated for the wrong reasons. If you like something, that's what's good.
That's cool. Larry the Editor sent in one of his Kiss albums, I believe from 1976. Oh my God. I was going to see if you wouldn't mind signing that for Larry today. This would be like official authentication if you sign it on live television. Okay, Larry's going to be worth a fortune.
Okay, you ready?
Here we go.
Here we go. Sign big.
All right, that's awesome.
And to Larry, so he can't sell it.
Oh, I was going to sell it on the way back. I was like, good luck, Larry, getting this back when, to our Good Day Atlanta studios,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you'd be going, what album?
You're open. You got restaurants. You got a lot of stuff coming up, rock and roll shows. It's good to be you.
It's good being me, and it's good to be you. You know, do what you love doing, and you'll never work a day in your life.
And one day, I hope to have a job where I can not wear sleeves. And that would be my goal.
And look that good.
I think you just have to spend a little more time in the gym.
Get in the gym. That's right. All right. Sharon, looks, back to you.
He looks amazing. Amazing. Yeah, I'm a bit starstruck
no
myself.
Doubt.
A bit starstruck. Thank you so much, Paul. I'm like, Paul. Yeah, Paul as well. Paul Stanley. And thank you, Buck. Paul Stanley's art show is tomorrow from 5 to 8 p.m. at the Wentworth Gallery at Fitz Plaza in Buckhead. How laid back is he and so cool? Gosh, she looks the same. Well, roses are a garden classic that people